Hi, so in this video, I just want to create a dedicated topic regarding how are we giving the students or the login user the points that we have set up. So the previous video where I've explained how this complete button is set up mentioned the points, but in this video, I'm just gonna focus on the points alone so that I hope it simplify the setup or the explanation of how I have set this up. So on the profile page, I have set up the meta box here. So this is really where we store and deduct the points of the users. That meta box, if you check that out here, so achievement, so it's only have this field. So the name is points and the object type is number. So you need to have this field first before we can do the math. Next, on the intro mark complete form, this is where we add the points. Right now, there's no deduction of points that I have set up in here, but you can do exactly the same setup. You just need to, rather than using the plus, let me just zoom in. Rather than using the plus, this part, you change this to minus and it will deduct that points. So I'm using the JetForm Builder to create some gamification. Since it easily recognizes those fields that I've set up with JetEngine, the JetForm Builder is very handy for this kind of functionality that you want. You just need to make sure that when, example, I added this form to the single post template of the lesson, it says the current post ID. So it's gonna pull the data from that current post, whichever that is. So it became dynamic. So current post ID, then user current ID, which is whoever's the login. And then it's gonna pull the lesson points, the one that we have set up here. So you can, this points field, right now it is set up to give this points if they have marked this lesson complete. But you can also do vice versa. Like if they don't have these points, then you can like not allow them to access this lesson. So that's another gamification that you can do. Maybe you have like bonus resources and say if you don't have these specific points, you can't access these bonus resources yet. And then the user points, again, we've covered that. And then here is the calculated one. So if I add a widget, it says here, calculated field. That's the one that I'm using. So here, if I, so if you click this tool icon, it's gonna give you the available fields that you can pull. So as you can see, it says I can pull the post ID, I can pull the user ID, I can pull the lesson points, and I can pull the user points. So that's what I'm using here. So I said, so if I'm gonna start from scratch, what it's gonna look is like blank. And I said, I want the lesson points to be added. So plus icon or plus to be added to the user points. So that's exactly similar to what I originally have here. And then this is, if once click this and then at the top, you need to set some name, right? So new total points. So if we go back to the JetForm settings under updated user, so here we have new total points, which is that field. We are storing that under the user meta, the field points. So under here. That's the field name, points. So that's how it works. That's how it passes the new points total from this form to the user points field. So I hope this video helps. And yeah, you can do vice versa, add or deduct, but that's how this point system is currently set up for this website. And yep, I'll see you in the next video.